we welcome you inside Arrowhead Stadium in Kansas City. Today, we've got a Week 8 matchup on tap here between the Dallas Cowboys and the Kansas City Chiefs. Lurching closer toward the midway point of this NFL season, and we're underway on EA Sports. And no return on this one as the fair catch is signaled for and taken. They'll start this drive out on the ground. They'll be dropped after a gain of about six across the 30 to the 31. This defense for the Cowboys, they were very strong last week in the win over Carolina.
And I think our statistician, we ended up having to bring the blue tent and put it around him for a while because he was developing a hand injury from having to write down all the turnovers this team forced. 5, 6, 7, 8. Absolutely unbelievable. I hope he'll recover.
From the 31, Lawrence. And this throw incomplete. Now the defender all over him that time, and it's going to lead to third down.
No surprise at all. They're looking for the big man early in this one. The only surprise for them, he can hang on to the pass.
Seriously, was that even a play?
They'll look to avoid an early three and out here on third and four.
All right, now let's get in that end zone.
Hands it off out of the gun. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. And that's a yard. It's enough for Chiefs first down.
Well, there's plenty of real estate for him to maneuver on that run, and let's face it, it shouldn't be a surprise. He's one of the better backs in the league. Had to come into this game with the idea, slow him down, otherwise it's going to be a long afternoon.
They go play action now, Lawrence. He rifles one, it's intercepted. Picked up by Calvin Joseph. And the Cowboys are going to take possession of the football. Well, that is a quick lesson on how difficult this defense is to throw against an interception on their initial drive of the ball game.
Now we know why their offensive staff spent the entire week awake trying to prepare for this one, because you can't totally shy away from throwing the football, but at the same time, you're looking at them and going, hey, where are the weaknesses? How are we going to move it?
One of the top defenses in the NFL for a reason. We just saw one example right there. He'll get eight on the keeper there. It'll be second and a couple. A little do-it-yourself run right there, and a nice game.
I like that he knew that that was about all he was going to get, so he did a nice job of protecting himself, took care of the football, took what the defense gave him. If they continue to allow him to do that, they'll find their way taking what they can all the way to the end zone.
Trying to run forward, and he gets the first down here as he's taken down at the 24. 7 yards there, good enough to move the sticks. If you make the stop there, maybe you hold them to three on this opening drive. They didn't get the stop.
Yeah, new set of downs now. Now you're worried about, just as you pointed out, not just giving up three, possibly giving up six. Let's see what they decide to do here, because they've got to change up what they have been doing. It hasn't been working.
And he will lose yardage and be backed up to the 24. He'll lose a yard there in second and 11.
This defense is a difficult one to prepare for. One of the best in the league. They'll come at you from all angles, and they did a nice job there stopping him for a loss.
So after the loss of a yard, they'll look to push forward here on second down and 11. Now they'll switch it up here, look to throw. And he'll find his big tight end over the middle. And brought down, but not before they get it inside the 10 to the 7. 18 yards that time to push him up, first and goal.
And remember, this drive started off following the turnover. And they've taken no time working their way down the short field. A nice connection there, and now they're looking at a first and goal.
passing yardage to the 11. It's a loss of 4 on the first down play.
Overall, I'd have to say that's just really good team defense, because to me, you can't pin that one on the running back. He had no shot there. He had a man in his face immediately.
So they get pushed back to the 11, and here's second and goal. He'll look to throw. And he's left with no option here but to throw it away. So it's third and goal now, and this is where the KC crowd can make it very tough. They'll look to throw on third and goal. And he takes it inside the 10 to the end. The decision to take the move gets him 3, but that's not enough. Now it's 4th. Now for the field goal try. Here's Eddie Pinheiro from the right hash, and this one just a chippy. The kick by Pinheiro is good. And the Cowboys are going to jump out to a 3-0 lead. Well, it's not the touchdown that they wanted, CD, but still, they got to be pretty happy here. You steal the ball away from them on their opening possession, and you turn that into the early 3-0 lead.
Yeah, you painted the picture perfectly there, all the things that have gone on. And the important thing, other than the lead, of course, is, as you described, both sides of the ball now have some momentum.
The Chiefs offense about set to begin this drive. For the first time out, they had the interception. That stopped their drive. 3 points the other way, so now they work from behind.
They do, but he's got to walk out on the field like he's working from ahead. All right, he's got to walk out like, hey, I just threw a touchdown pass, because all eyes on his team are on him. They gain their confidence from the way he reacts, his demeanor, and how he plays. He's got to show that he has confidence in himself.
The last play got just a yard. Here's second and 9 from the 26. And they'll keep leaning on the running. And now on the pitch, the ball's loose. It's picked up by the Cowboys. And they take possession of the football and have it at the 36-yard line. And they put it on the ground here on the second drive. And, of course, Charles, that follows drive number 1 where they had the INT.
Makes you wonder what's going on with this team, because a lot of times we can attribute it to nerves, but maybe it's a lack of focus. Maybe it's the preparation for the game. Maybe they just came into a little lackadaisical, because that's just not looking good at all. That's just not the football that we came here to see.
The first play of the drive there is incomplete.
I'll give them credit winning that first snap. That's a really It's a little bit if they took the field charged up after taking over after a turnover.
After the incomplete pass, here now is second and 10. He'll look to throw. A short one here, complete to his tight end. And he is out. Coming up here looking for 3 yards to pick up the first. On third and short, they'll try and pick it up through the air. Lamb, it's complete. And he will have a Cowboys first down as they're able to get the third down conversion.
I think when they look at their offense, they think to themselves, weapons everywhere. And they want to move the ball around. They want to spread it to different people. But you absolutely know they want to get this man involved as well. And that's what they just did on that play.
And they run the option here on first and 10. And able to get him down, but he does reach the 5.
That's a 12-yard gain now on back-to-back plays.
And this, I mean, it's certainly something to watch out for. He is not afraid to call his own number on plays like that, and here he takes it for good yardage.
And we know this defense prepared all week for this, but sometimes when you see it in person, it's a whole different ball game, and all that preparation, it goes right out the window.
And not a whole lot there. He does get a couple, taking it from the 5 down to the 3. Be interesting to see now what they do offensively down near the goal line after not much there that time.
As the offensive play caller, that may change your sequence now. Instead of coming right back with a running play, you may have to go to the air.
And he is met in his tracks. This is up and good from Pinheiro, and that will make it 6-0. So able to add on to their first half lead here, Charles, forcing the miscue with a fumble and then turning that into 3 points.
Yeah, and more than happy to accept any mistakes the other side is willing to make. No problem. You turn it over, we'll take that, and we'll use it to expand our lead.
KC offense out of the huddle, ready for their next drive. Well, they have the game here followed by the open date on their calendar next weekend. And Charles, this is a crew that you have to think really is relishing the opportunity to be on the couch for a few days.
Yeah, they certainly are, but let's face it, partner. They can't get caught looking ahead to that couch time while they're playing this one. They've got to take care of business first.
40 yards on that last carry. Here's 2nd and 7. And they'll give him another shot here on the ground. And he'll take this to the 32, a gain of about 3.
I do know from experience that when you slow down someone's running game, you're now doing the dictating on defense. And guess what? Now you're getting ready to tee off on their quarterback because they have to throw it all the time. But you still have to be alert for the draws and other plays of that nature to make sure you don't get hurt.
Lawrence on 3rd down. And this is incomplete. Oh, it looked like he had a pretty good line on that one. That would have been a big play, but he could not pull it in. On 4th down, Ryan Stonehouse on the punt. He was only asked to punt once in the victory last week as he sends this one away. Taken in at the 11. We'll call that a punt of 54 yards. Well struck. And the Cowboys will take over the football with a 1st and 10. Set for this next drive by the Cowboys offense. And their 2 drives thus far both led to points, albeit by field goals, so the lead just 6-0, but the ability to move the ball is evident.
Well, that's, you know, heartening, as they say, but it's not what they're about. What they're about is putting the ball in the end zone and putting 6s on the board. So if you're the offensive coordinator, you like what you're doing, but you don't love it. You've got to find a way to ring that bell. Then you can have a little self-satisfied grin. Right now, a little more determination is needed.
Come on. After the end. incompletion here, second and 10 from the 20.
Ready?
The play action fake. They'll look to throw. He's going to go for a big play downfield. And it's knocked away and incomplete. What the This is third and 10.
Ultra.
They'll look to throw. And the Chiefs are going to get it. Here's Mitch Wishnowski now. They only punted twice in the win last week as he gets this one away. Now a fair catch taken just across midfield, maybe by a yard or two. It'll wind up just a 35-yard punt, no return. And it's Chiefs football, first and 10. The Chiefs offense about set to begin this drive. Well, partner, fast forward with me for a second. Remember, next week they have the open week, so they're going to get some extended rest. Does that change how they manage the rest of this one?
I think it does a little bit, but not by too much, because you're right. You get the extra rest, you get a chance to heal up and kind of, you know, do a little bit of a reset for this team. But it's also 7 extra days to think back to the last time you were on the field. So now a little more importance on what they're getting done, because they carry it with them for essentially 2 weeks.
They'll go option on second down, right side. And a strong run there as he'll take this all the way down to the 35. I tell you, there is no antidote for speed, even at the quarterback position, as he keeps it himself and turns it into good yardage.
And it still takes time for a defender to react. Even as quarterbacks carry the ball more and more in today's NFL, they're still a little bit in disbelief and realize, oh my goodness, he's running with the ball. He may be 8, 10, 12 yards downfield at that point.
Hey, Echo.
And they'll throw on first down with Lawrence. He's going to flip it up here to his right hand. They'll get it inside the 20. And they'll get this down to about the 17-yard line here.
And I like the idea here. Get the ball in his hands, even if it's in the passing game. 3 catches a week ago, and he does a nice job here to pick up yardage.
This offense finding its legs now. Here's another first and 10. And they'll run on the inside handoff. And he'll get about 3 as he's taken down at the 14-yard line. Just not a whole lot of room to operate there on that carry.
No, not at all. They did a really nice job staying in their proper places and not allowing any lanes to open up.
And the last run got 3. Now here's 2nd and 7.
Running game helping out, picking up some of the slack. Because remember, last drive, they went 3 and out.
The kicker fest so far, all points via field goals. They're hoping to change that right here. A snap to Lawrence as he taps this forward. And a minuscule gain of maybe a yard from the 6 to the 5. A nice play design there with the touch pass. Looked good at the start, but bottom line, the defense was ready.
And they did a nice job scouting, didn't they? Not just scouting, but now executing once they saw the play for real after having worked on it all week in practice. They drilled on the play, then they drilled him.
On 2nd down, they'll run it here. And he will push his way forward down to about the 3-yard line.
Pick it up, you're embarrassing.
A gain of 2 there on the heels of a 1-yard pickup on first.
That run didn't get very far, and I think when you're looking at his dimensions, a little bit on the smaller side, he's counting on the big guys up front to escort him in, and they couldn't create any kind of space for him, could they?
Yeah, didn't get the push they needed.
Go.
A great job to hold him to just 1 yard there. Now it's fourth and goal.
As a defense, you're more balanced when you're in zone coverage because you're able to keep your eyes on the quarterback and see the play develop in front of you. They're able to keep the quick pass in front of them and stop it right at the line of scrimmage.
Here we go.
They'll come out in the pistol. They get this out quickly to the left side. A great open field tackle is going to stop him shy of the goal line. They get the completion but cannot push forward into the end zone. And this Cowboy defense comes up with a goal line stand.
Ready up.
About set for this next drive by the Cowboys offense. And they're about to come up on drive number four, but so far just two field goals on drives one through three.
Wondering if the head coach is talking to his offense coordinator and said, look, let's go and press this in another game. I'm giving you four downs on just about every occasion to try and get this offense kick-started and have it culminate in touchdowns. You know, maybe someday you press it a little bit. This might be the case.
The last run good for two. Here's second and eight. Here's Pollard again. And he's taken down, but able to get this up to the 20-yard line. They were looking for a cushion from that end zone, and he gave it to him, 15 big yards. So the previous play, a big help, as now they'll have it first and 10 up at the 20. Chased, and he's going to be brought down. Back in his own 6-yard line. The defense rising to the challenge and setting him back on the sand.
Now that was a passer's nightmare. The front door totally shut down by the defense, and he kept going backwards, hoping to find another avenue of escape. It didn't exist.
Right here, one time.
They're going to look to throw. Oh, he's got a man wide open, complete. A good remaining in this first half of football. Now on third down, an extra DB out there for the Chiefs. Fourth down, here's the Australian native Mitch Wishnowsky to punt this one away. On that punt, we've got a man shaken up. We'll step aside and get an update when we return to KC. Good starting field position for them as they come up first and 10 at their own 44. They'll start this drive out on the ground. And he's got this one across midfield into Cowboy territory. It's a 7-yard carry to set them up with a second and three.
Well, no matter how they phrase it, staying on schedule, staying ahead of the sticks, whatever you want to call it, 7 yards on first down, that fits the bill.
So they'll come up after the gain of 7 on a second and 3. Here's Lawrence. Finding a safety valve here. That's complete. And he'll go down inside the 45 before going out of bounds. A gain of 5, good enough for the first down.
And we see another pitch and catch there to the running back. This position just continues to evolve. They've become just as critical to the passing attack as a lot of receivers, tight ends, because their ability to make people miss in the open field can really generate big plays for an offense.
On first and 10. It's Lawrence. And he will go down. A Cowboys sack. Micah Parsons in there to get him, and that is sack number 6 now for him on the year.
Okay, I'm not sure you could actually draw a better pass rush than that one right there. Nowhere to go outside. He had to keep backing up and backing up and backing up. Eventually dropped for a huge loss.
Another try after the first down sack. Lawrence. And incomplete on the deep ball.
This team is not going to make it easy for you. There's physical ground you just saw there on that play. He came in, made the contact, just as he's trying to haul it in.
Do better than this.
An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means he'll need to come up with something here on third down. Here's Lawrence to throw. Into a double team, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Marquise Bell. And the Cowboys are going to take possession as they've got it at the 42-yard line.
When a team's turned it over 3 times in the first half, we just look at the offense and say, guys, what are you doing? But instead, we really should be looking at the defense. They've created the takeaways. 2 interceptions, 1 cause fumble. They played awfully well swarming to the ball here in the first half.
Let's go.
About set for this next drive by the Cowboys offense. And with good starting field position and 3 timeouts as well in their pocket, no reason not to try and put a late scoring drive together. They start on the ground with Elliott. And he'll be brought down at the 48-yard line. Now the Cowboys going to burn the first of their timeouts as they'll stop it with 27 seconds remaining here in the second quarter. They still need about the length of the football here, maybe a little less, as they come up on second and inches. Got this into the hands of the tight end, Jordan. Now another timeout called for by the offense. So that means they're down to 1 remaining here as we head toward halftime.
It certainly feels like there are more stars at the tight end position than there were even 10 years ago. And I think it's become more of a glamour position because of the ways it can hurt a defense. And guys want to be involved. They can be in line, close to the line of scrimmage. They can split out like receivers. But hands, route running, speed, and some toughness to go across the middle, you put it all together, you got heck of a tight end candidate.
Toward the sideline, and look at that catch. Dragging the toes, and that's going to be a first down. Well done. A good pickup there, 21 yards.
Let's make this one simple. What a catch, especially the finishing part of getting his feet in bounds, toe tapping, and of course, foot dragging.
A little tapestry, if you will.
Oh, I like it.
They'll look to throw here on first down. That's caught. Touchdown, Cowboys. CeeDee Lamb, as the first half is winding down. And the Cowboys will extend their lead here just before halftime. Pinheiro's extra point up and good. And the lead now stands at 13. So not much time to speak of remaining in this first half as the kick's away. This one taken just inside. Now a hit and a loose football. And I believe he was able to get this back. He was. Boy, after giving up the touchdown, lucky that didn't turn into another.
I didn't do this in college, but I did it in high school. When you return kicks and you lose it yourself, the panic that goes through you and the determination to get the ball back, I don't even know how to describe it. And I think we just saw an example there.
Yeah, and the relief when you get it back like he did.
Yeah, you go to the sidelines, you know you're going to get yelled at, but you can handle it because you got the ball back.
The KC offense out of the huddle, ready for their next drive. And with 7 seconds remaining, not much time to really do anything. And he'll be out of bounds across the 30-yard line. And at his size, he's a smaller back. You can get him to football. He can kind of get lost, make someone miss. It's good for him.
Yeah, it's great for him. I like what you said there. Sometimes he gets lost in the traffic a little bit, but get him out in the open field into some space. That plays to his strengths the best and keeps him out of it where all the big boys are, you know, make him make someone miss in the open field.
This time they'll just keep this on the ground and brought down, but not before reaching the 45-yard line. So we have reached halftime here with the visiting Cowboys out on top. As we'll send you down to Orlando, we check in with Jonathan Coachman for our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach, welcome back. Halftime over. We are ready for quarter number three. Alongside Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gordon. The Cowboys will get the football first here, and they have the lead as well as we are underway in quarter three. This one fielded at the five. And taken down just past the 20 at about the 21-yard line.
Here we go.
About set for this next drive by the Cowboys offense. They've got the lead. CD, what do you think the message was at halftime?
I don't think the message was too drastic, I think, at the half, or that they need to change things too much. I do think the offensive line could play a little bit better. I think they'll try and help them out more. They'll probably keep a tight end in a few more times and maybe add a running back to the formation to pick up those pass rushers, because they probably allowed a few too many sacks for comfort in the first half.
Second and four. Oh, he tries to force it in, and it's intercepted. And the Chiefs are going to take possession of the football. That is just what this defense was hoping for, an interception on the opening possession of this third quarter.
Obviously didn't want to surrender a touchdown and fall even farther behind. And we've gotten to know this team a little bit, haven't we? Couldn't you just see their defensive leaders telling the offensive guys, telling the quarterback, don't worry, we got you to start things off. You take it from there.
Here's a throw to his running back. It's complete. And he'll be out of bounds as he gets it down to the 30 there. A lot of effort there for just a 3-yard gain, and now second down. He was out there waving his arms, and when you got a quarterback out of the pocket looking for any help, I guess waving the arms is helpful.
It certainly is, because you got to get his attention, because now you're in scramble drill. So everyone's adjusting their routes, finding open space, and he found the right spot for the completion.
And a strong run there as he'll maneuver his way down inside the 15. 65 yards for him on the ground. And he's been terrific here this afternoon.
I'm okay with the call there. In fact, I actually like it. I know they're down a couple of scores, but the running game worked in that situation. I would continue to go in that direction.
There's a first and 10 at the 14-yard line. One back in the backfield, he'll get the carry. And he's brought down just outside of the 10 at the 11. Call it a gain of four on first, and that'll make it second down.
Not a run that you're going to write home about, but still a good first down run. That's what an offense calls staying on schedule. 3 to 4 yards on first down, you're set up very well for the rest of the drive.
The run got four. Now they deal with a second and six. On play action, Lawrence. And he fires one incomplete.
The goal is certainly to try and make a big play happen and climb back into this game, but you have to be careful. If you overdo it, you could turn it over and hurt your team.
What the hell was that? Are you kidding me?
Justice Christ.
Come on.
Wait for this.
So after the second down incompletion, they'll come up now against a third and six. Looking to throw, Lawrence. He's going to be intercepted for the third time thus far. Picked off by Trayvon Diggs. And he's free going down the left side. It's a foul race. And he takes this one back into the end zone, and the Cowboy defense has a touchdown.
Well, I mean, you get it. They're trying to make something happen here this third quarter, CD, but I don't think a pick six is exactly what they had in mind.
No, not at all, because this offense, they've been stuck all game long. Haven't dented the scoreboard yet, and they're kind of forced to take a few chances here, and that one, it backfired in a big way.
And his kick is good, and flags fly as well. Some frustration showing through right now. This is going to be a roughing call. So they'll get another shot on offense following that pick six, and now the kick is away. And a fair catch signaled for and taken successfully. First and 10, and they've got three tight ends out there. A jumbo package look. They'll start this drive out on the ground. And he stopped immediately there. Brought down by Devin Harper.
As usual, the hallmark of a good run defense, linebackers making plays near the line of scrimmage. Absolutely nowhere to run there.
Officially nothing on that last run. They'll try again second and 10. And they'll keep leaning on the running game back to the ground. And this will be a gain of 5 as he gets it to the 30.
I really like the vision he displayed on that play because he saw there wasn't a lane to completely break off a huge gain. So he found where there was the most space and got what he could. A nice, dirty run that's a positive play for the offense.
This offense in desperate need of a conversion as they come up on third down.
On the buffet.
They go play action with Lawrence. He's got a man. It's his tight end. That's complete. And he's out of bounds, able to take this one up to the 35. Give him a gain of 5 on the completion. And it'll be fourth down.
I thought maybe when he caught, he'd have a good chance of getting that first down, but that's a nice job of holding him up and preventing him from getting to the sticks.
They'll try and run for it. They only needed a few inches, but still some anxious moments there, but they do convert on fourth. Just enough push up front. He only needed about 6 inches. He didn't get a whole lot more than that.
No, but he made sure he got enough so they didn't have to worry about measuring it or making it even close. Ends up picking up a couple of yards in a situation, as you noted, where he only needed inches.
Meanwhile, Lawrence's throw here caught by Mims. And able to get this one across the 45 before he's brought down. 11 yards for number 11.
Well, we talk all the time about playing situational football, and right now, I think the scoreboard is dictating what they need to do. Where they are in this game, they've got to push the ball downfield, take their shots, try and get big chunks of yardage in a short amount of time. That was a nice play there.
3 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be second down.
Give credit to the defense for stringing that play out, and they gave up no cutback angle. You know he was trying to dart through. No place for him to go. A nice job there, only giving up a 3-yard gain.
Second down at 7.
Let's go!
Lawrence taking a deep shot here for Hardman. And his pass is intercepted for the 4th time today. Picked off by Kelvin Joseph. And the Cowboys are going to get the football here at their own 40-yard line. Well, still down quite a bit here, several scores, but yeah, at least that's a start, Charles, getting the interception here. And look, we're still in the third quarter, so this thing not done yet.
You're right about that, Brandon. This defense, they haven't quit on this game. They stayed with it and got an interception and handed the ball back to their offense. And what you wonder about is the team that just threw that interception, they've got to be careful about developing a sense of complacency and thinking this game is over.
Now, meanwhile, a pass that should have been intercepted, but it winds up falling incomplete.
You know he has a lot of confidence in his arm and likes to force it downfield, but the coverage was tight there. Fortunate it wasn't picked off.
A third quarter action from Kansas City, second down and 10. Now they'll run the option to the short side left. And that play went nowhere. Losing yardage, it'll be back at the 36. He lost four there, and it's third down.
Well, that play never really got off the launching pad. He had a linebacker in his face before he had a chance to do much of anything.
Yeah, I think his big boys up front, that offensive line, they've got to do a little bit better job of protecting him if they're going to continue to run the option like this.
Going to need a crafty play call here. 14 yards is what they need to try to convert this thing. That is caught by Lamb. And he will have a Cowboys first down as they're able to get the third down conversion.
And while we may be looking at the scoreboard, this offense certainly is not, because they're showing no signs of backing down, even with a three-score lead here in the third quarter. I think they keep taking their shots. They've seen blown leads happen throughout this league. They don't want to fall victim to it themselves.
They'll go with Pollard here on first down. And he gets forward up the middle, but only for a couple. It'll be second down. In the first half, he was held in check on the ground, but despite that lack of production, they still have the lead.
Yeah, and they've got to feel fortunate about that. If they could actually get production from their lead horse, that would help open up this offense and widen this margin, too.
The last run got a couple. Here's second and eight. Gonna run again here with Pollard. And he'll get it down on the play to the 37. Call that a gain of five as the clock ticks inside of 2 minutes to go now in the third.
Well, you certainly have to give a little credit here, because they're playing this game now at their pace. This is ball control football, sustained runs, taking their time, and making it work.
You yellow.
They'll set up to throw. Throwing left side here, and it's complete. And he'll be brought down with a first down as the tackle's made at the Chiefs 18. Right about 20 yards on the pickup. Officially, they'll say it's going to go for 19.
So first and 10, and if they score on this drive, might have to start digging in our second half blowout material.
Blue strike.
Here's a little touch pass as they tap it quickly to their receiver. And he's able to get this inside the 10 now to the 9.
And a lot of times these plays, they either go for nothing or they go for big yardage. And here, they got to the outside, turned it upfield, and ended up getting a nice little gain out of it.
Here we go.
Line of scrimmage, the 9. Second and about a yard. And they're not going to get to the line to run another play. So we will switch ends as the third quarter has come to a close. This is the National Football League on EA Sports. Here's second and a yard. The stop will come inside the 5 at the 4. 4 yards on the play. That's going to lead to first and goal.
Starting to feel a little to me like the air is coming out of the balloon, so to speak, defensively.
They're taking their will from them right now. That's what they're doing. Whatever they want to call, it's working. They're handling things up front. And it's not just the offensive line. It's everyone. You're seeing the guys on the perimeter blocking downfield and making sure that they're secure. So, yeah, you're exactly right. The air is out of the balloon. And right now, they're almost lifeless. That's a nice job there defensively, being able to diagnose that little touch pass. They saw it coming, converged on him before he could get much out of it.
Ready, set.
Line of scrimmage, again, the 4-yard line, second and goal.
Ready, set.
That's out to the left, flat and complete. Touchdown! A great effort there. His first touchdown on the year. And the Cowboys are about to make it four straight as they add to this fourth quarter advantage. Pinheiro's extra point up and good. And that stretches the lead all the way up to 27. Here is Wisnowski to boot it away following the touchdown. Fielded right around the 8. And able to get this out to the 25. The Chiefs offense about set to begin this drive. And just looking ahead, it would appear that that bye week is coming at the right time. They'll have 2 weeks to chew on this one, though probably not one that they want to chew on. A poor performance from start to finish. Just a yard on the pickup there, and it'll bring up a 2nd and 9.
Ladies and gentlemen, that is a force of nature at the defensive tackle position. Yes, he's as big as they come, but still plenty agile. He's able to make a nice play there to swallow up the ball carrier.
Here we go. The run only got a yard. Here's 2nd and 9.
Hit it.
And they'll give him another shot here on the ground. And he powers his way up past the 30. Call it a gain of 5 that time, and they'll be left with a 3rd and about 4.
It's not a huge breakaway run, but if your starting running back finishes the game with averages of 5 or 6 yards per touch, you'll take that every single time.
This offense so far on 3rd down, they've had their troubles, just 1 for 6. This is 3rd and 4. One back in the backfield, he'll get the carry. And he's able to get the first before he's taken down at the 36. They get 5 out of that one, and it moves the chains.
On 3rd down, that's a good job of situational football and understanding where the 1st down marker was and getting there.
On 1st down, they'll go to the ground attack. And some good acceleration there as he's across midfield. So on the other side of the field now, it's 1st and 10, as they've got things rolling on this drive. Here's a handoff out of the gun, and not a whole lot of room to operate there on the 1st down run. He gets maybe 3.
This drive is pretty clear. Almost feels like old school fundamentals, doesn't it? Want to impose their will on the defense. What's that, 5 straight runs?
Yeah, 5 straight carries to start this drive, and like you said, the way it's working, they may just stick with it. And now a first chance for the backup here to throw. This one complete to Mecole Hardman. And he's going to have another 1st down here as the tackle's made at the Cowboys' 27-yard line. 17 yards is the pickup number 17. That's just his 2nd catch of the game. They wanted to keep him silent. They have kept him silent.
Defensive football 101. Don't let the best player on offense beat you. Take him out of the game. They've done a great job of doing that.
They go play action here on 1st down. He's going to let it go deep for the end zone. And that is incomplete.
Too many zeros on the stat sheet thus far. No touchdown passes, no points for his team, but he remains undaunted. Still attempting to get his team on the scoreboard, firing the ball downfield.
2nd and 10 now from the 27. He'll look to throw. Firing quickly, but it's incomplete.
And that's another play that's painted the picture of this game overall. It's been a blowout. It's been continually fueled by big turnovers and stops for one side and an inability to advance the ball from the other.
Here we go.
This offense was on the move. Now 2 straight incompletions have him looking at 3rd and 10. Again, he'll drop to throw. He's got his man. That's Hardman. And they've got it inside the 10 at the 8. They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up a first and goal.
Well, this game is certainly pretty well over. They go ahead and mark it in the win column. But as a defense, they don't want to get so soft now that everybody just throws the ball all over the place against them, gets big yardage, and puts points on the board. They have pride, too, on that side of the ball.
And he's going to go down, sacked right around the 17. The sack sets him back a full 10 yards there on first and goal.
First and goal looked like things were set up nicely, and now all of a sudden on second and goal, Charles, a big challenge ahead of them.
And you have to know, when you're this close to the goal line, things are going to happen faster, so you've got to get the ball out quick. Not going to have much time in the pocket before the defenders bring pressure.
They'll drop to throw. That's caught right side by Mims. Really nice gain on the completion. However, still third and goal that they face now.
And that was yardage that they needed there after the sack on first down. They didn't get all of it back. But now they look at third down as a manageable situation, one that they have a much better chance of picking up.
18 Rattler.
They'll look to throw on third and goal. Buying time to his left. And he's got Hardman in the end zone. Touchdown, Kansas City. A great play there. His sixth touchdown of the season.
And the Chiefs are finally on the board here in the fourth quarter. Extra point up.
So still lots. This one travels out of bounds, so unsuccessful there on the onside kick try.
Ready.
So good starting field position for him here as they come up first and 10, just shy of midfield at the 48. They'll try to run some clock now with Elliott. Trying to run inside, but nothing there. Nick Bolton there on the tackle. And in this situation with a lead fourth quarter, they're liking keeping the ball on the ground, I'm sure.
That's just smart football, but you know the defense has to know it as well. They've got to stop them here. So now we're going to see that loading the box in a big way. 6, 7, 8, 9, whatever it's going to take, puts a little bit more pressure on your big offensive line.
And not a lot of success to be found there.
Oh, you got that right, partner, because if you're trying to make guys miss about 10 yards or so downfield, that's a pretty good play. But if you've got to do it in your own backfield, I consider that a problem. That doesn't work here too well.
And not an easy spot here. They'll be in search of 13 yards to try to pick up the first.
Now on third and long, they'll look to throw. He's going to look deep down the field. And this is going to be intercepted.
Trent McDuffie with a pick.
And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. Shot here for Hardman. And it's caught inside the 30.
And he's brought down here just outside of the 20. We saw this plenty last year in college. He loved to take his shots downfield, and that throw, that was a thing to behold there.
And that's how you start a drive, because you know they had this play in their back pocket, waiting for the right time to unleash it. And boy, did they pick the right opportunity. Unleashed it big time. And that was also a big time throw.
And you can see in the next gen stats that one 62 yards in the air.
Now a play fake here on first down.
Oh, this one incomplete. The pressure got to him as he released it. And it's second down.
At this point in the game, they've got to continue to try anything they can. They're still working at it, even though this one feels like a lost cause.
From the 21, it's second and 10. The play action fake. They'll look to throw. Steps away. He's got him complete. And he'll be out of bounds, taking it just shy of the 10 at the 11 or the 12. 9 yards, not quite enough, and they'll be left now with third and one.
And that's why you do all the drills that you do from the quarterback position, because you're not going to just throw to your strength. The right-handed quarterback naturally will want to move to the right side to throw the football. But sometimes you've got to go left, and that's exactly what happened on that play. Forced to his left, still able to accurately throw it downfield for a completion.
We need this. Let's do it.
Buffalo 18.
They'll look to throw again. Oh, this will be incomplete. The rush gets home just as he was letting that go. That could have been worse. Instead, it's fourth down. What we just saw there, that's really been a common theme all afternoon.
A lot of pressure. That forced the errant pass. He's been under duress this entire afternoon. He just had to unload that when he's fortunate. It was just incomplete and not intercepted.
And I'm not sure he got there. Did they stop him? They did. Such little time remaining, and the Cowboys defense is going to get them the